What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be sharing with you a healthy low sugar jam recipe that is high in omega-3s and only takes about 15 minutes to make. This is super easy to make, fully customizable, and I think it's great value for what you're getting. So without further ado, let's get right into making these jams. I'll be making three different jams out of three different fruits today, and they are a blackberry jam, raspberry jam, and a blueberry jam. Berries are naturally high in antioxidants and vitamins, and if you can't get hold of fresh berries, or if they're just currently too expensive because they're out of season for you now, frozen berries are a great option, and these are what I'll be using today. Frozen berries still retain a lot of their nutritional value and can sometimes still be cheaper than fresh versions even when they are in season, and you'll be able to access them even when they're not in season. Don't worry about defrosting them as we'll be heating them up in the saucepan, and of course, you're not limited to just these three berry types, you can use any berry that you like with these same ingredient ratios. Also with today's jams, I'll be using three different sweeteners to give you options to choose from, depending on your preference. The first sweetener is stevia, and this is a low calorie option. Stevia is a natural sweetener derived from a leaf, which has the same sweetness as sugar, but has less than 10% of the calories of sugar per gram. The second sweetener is maple syrup, which is a vegan and a refined sugar-free option. Maple syrup has a lower GI score than sugar, meaning that maple syrup raises blood sugar slower than regular sugar. The final sweetener type is raw sugar, and this is a refined sugar, but it's also the most economical option. Of course, there is a fourth choice, which is that you could add no sugar at all. This is good if you like tart jams and flavors, as sometimes these berries can be a little sour. To make the jam, weigh out 300 grams of the berries of your choice and put this into a saucepan on medium flame. Slowly stir them as they defrost and start releasing some of their juices. This takes about 5 minutes and you may already see some of the fruits start to break down. Add in 1 tablespoon of the sweetener of your choice and keep stirring until fully distributed in your fruit. The amount of sweetener needed depends on how sweet your fruits are in the first place and of course what your taste preference is. Normal jams are nearly a 1-to-1 ratio of sugar to fruit because traditionally you're using the sugar to set the jam. In this recipe, the sweetener is only for taste, and I like my jams a little tart, so I found 1 tablespoon to be perfect. If you like yours a little sweeter, add another tablespoon or 2 to your taste. Once the sweetener you've chosen is well mixed in, add 1.5 tablespoons of chia seeds, and again, mix well with your fruit. Chia seeds are high in omega-3s and will help thicken up our jam. Keep mixing for another couple of minutes until the seeds are fully distributed in the mixture. Next, we're going to remove our pan from the heat and using an immersion blender, lightly pulse the mixture. Pulse it to the consistency that you like, whether it's still a little chunky or if you prefer it more smooth. This step is to break up some of those chia seeds, which will set the jam for us. You can also use a pour-in blender, just be careful as hot liquids can cause the lids to pop off of those. At this stage, your mixture will still look quite fluid like this, and that's okay because the broken up chia seeds just needs a little time to thicken up. Transfer your jam to a jar. Here, I'm just using some old olive jars that I removed the label from, so don't feel like you have to buy anything new. I actually have a video on 5 useful things you shouldn't throw away, and food jars are one of the items. You could check that video out after this one if you're interested. Once it's all in the jar, refrigerate for at least an hour to allow the chia seeds to set the jam, or even better if you could leave it overnight. And that's a healthy jam recipe that is low in sugar and high in omega-3s. These will keep for a couple of weeks, making sure to keep them refrigerated. Once my jams were set, I got these cute little tags and twine from Kmart, and I just did up some labels for the jars. I think these would make great little gifts when you're visiting a friend's place, and I'm also thinking about making some cranberry jam as little Christmas gifts this year. For a quick cost breakdown, here is the cost per quantity of each of the ingredients. In total, the cost of a 300 gram jar of jam was Aussie dollars 2.91 using stevia, about $3 using maple syrup, and 2.66 using raw sugar. Of course, ingredient costs will vary depending on where you live, so use the option that best suits you. But I think overall, this is a great value option considering that it's low time and effort, can be made reasonably priced, and is definitely healthier than traditional store-bought jams without losing out on flavor and texture. Alright, I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did enjoy it, please like, share, comment, and subscribe, because it really helps to support my channel, and I come out with healthy recipe videos every week. If you like jam and scones like I do, I'll be sharing a healthy scones recipe in my next video. These scones have no butter at all, but they have a really nice buttery texture to them. So why not turn that notification bell on so you get notified when that video is released. In the meantime, you could also check out my other healthy recipe videos in the playlist over here. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!